But he has a bill on it. Which
I heard there's a lot of action in this.
Good.
We also have Senator Galvin, Senator O'Meara, and Senator Gennaro. So we have a forum.
Thank you. Our first bill is Senate 1701 by Senator Sampson.
Senator, this is an act to amend the penal law in relation to increasing penalties for the identity theft crimes. This bill raises each degree of identity theft in the penal law by one class, making the lowest level a Class E felony and the highest level a Class D felony. This passed the Senate unanimously in 2005.
Okay. Move it. Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you. Moved and seconded. Any questions or comments? Negative votes. Bill is reported. Senate 2361 by Senator Seward.
Senator, this is an act to amend the penal law in relation to restrictions imposed by statute regarding the carrying of concealed weapons. This bill requires licensing officers around the state to conform to the criteria set forth in Section 400 of the penal law for the types of pistol permits that may be issued pursuant to statute and eliminate the practice of licensing officers imposing additional conditions on license holders that are not authorized by statute.
Move it. Seconded. Questions?
Questions. As I read this bill, it requires any regulation of concealed weapons to be only by state authority, by state statute. Is that correct?
The 400 statute is what authorizes the concealed weapon permit. It applies to New York City as well. It applies to New York City as well, although New York City has a special permit for permits issued outside of New York City.
Right, but I'm just trying to understand that this would remove local authority from restricting concealed weapons beyond what state statute might do. Is that correct?
This limits local licensing officers to what is delineated in the state, in the statute.
So, in other words, if New York City would decide for its own purposes that it wanted more restrictive permits on concealed weapons, this would supersede that and nullify anything the city would do?
I don't believe so, Senator. What this is if you're licensed under this section, then the licensing authority cannot add additional conditions. If you're licensed under New York City's statute, then that's the statute that would apply. In New York City, I think it said that supersedes. So this would just simply say that if your only licensure is under this section, then the practice that some courts have been is making up their own conditions. Certain hours they're allowed to carry or so on and so forth, causing inconsistency outside of New York City, but it's not intended to affect the conditions that New York City has by their own statute.
And the city has its own separate, I mean, as you well know, there's nobody outside of New York City who can carry in. The other 57 counties who can carry in New York City. And New York City has a different threshold, for lack of a better term, and virtually everybody else is extremely difficult.
So this would not affect anything that New York City does not issue permits pursuant to this. Okay, then another example, say the city of Rochester or some other non-New York City locality decides to have a more restrictive concealed weapons permit or restrictions on the existing permit, this would not allow that to happen. Is that?
No, they would have a second. If they were not preempted by the state law, it was permissible for them to have their own local law that added additional restrictions, then that would be where your permit would come from. So this would not affect it. It's only if this is the way that you're permitted.
But this must be happening somewhere, or else this would be necessary.
It's not by local law. It's by discretion of the licensing judge,
right,
who he or she takes upon themselves to create new conditions, and it's by individual.
So let me restate the question.
Outside of the city of New York, generally, it's a county court judge.
Okay.
And there are examples, and I believe it has occurred in Westchester County and may well have occurred in, I'm not sure about Suffolk, but I think it has occurred in Westchester where a local law has been requested to change licensing requirements or to limit the duration, more appropriately, of somebody's license requiring them to reapply.
So whether it's Westchester or Suffolk or Nassau or Monroe or wherever, this bill would say that that local licensing authority would not be allowed to add restrictions onto the state permit for concealed weapons.
Unless they're in the statute.
Unless they're authorized by statute.
Right. Okay. Well, I think the local discretion is important. I think the local authorities oftentimes have a better sense of what is going on in these communities than oftentimes we do here at the state level. And one blanket rule the entire state, I would suggest, is short-sighted and would unduly restrict localities and local authorities from doing what they need to do, so I will be voting for negative.
Any other questions or comments? Negative votes. Senator Perkins, Senator Gianaris.
Without rec.
Senator Golden without rec. Charlene?
Oh, I'm sorry. We do have, are you asking if I have that vote?
Yes.
We've got 5 ayes and 4 nays. I'm sorry.
All that.
Can I come back to it?
Let me see.
Oh, you're an aye. We do have an aye.
Can I get the vote count?
Let me see. We've got Senator Solanas an aye. Steve Francisco is an aye. Senator Jenkins an aye. Senator Picciolo is an aye. Senator Gallivan is an aye. Senator Golden is an aye without rec. Senator Romanza is an aye. Senator Nizzolio, we don't have a vote for. Senator O'Mara is an aye. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We are short one vote.
We'll keep the roll open and we'll see what happens at the end of the meeting.
Yeah, I'm getting more sheets in.
Move the bill. You want to table consideration of the bill at this point?
What would you like me to do, Chairman?
We'll table consideration of the bill at this point.
Okay, we will table, table the bill at this point.
Okay.
Seconded. All those in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed. Bill's tabled. Senate 2596A by Senator Flanagan.
Senator, this is an act to amend the penal law in relation to penalties for causing serious injury or death while knowingly operating a motor vehicle with a revoked or suspended license. The bill amends the vehicular assault and the second degree statute and the vehicular manslaughter statute, creating liability under each when a person commits either crime and knows or has reason to know that his license is suspended pursuant to certain mandatory suspension or revocation provisions of the BTL. It's passed the Senate 61-1 in 2011.
Motion. Moved by Senator Fischel, seconded by Senator Gallivan. Questions or comments? Negative votes. Bill is recorded. I'm sorry? Without rec, Senator Perkins. Senate 2940 by Senator Lanza.
Senator, this is an act to amend the penal law in relation to criminal street gang recruitment on school grounds and to amend certain other laws in relation to placement of gang-free school zone signs. The bill creates a new crime of criminal street gang recruitment on school grounds in the enterprise corruption of article of the penal law. This new Class D felony is committed on school grounds when a person coerces, solicits, recruits, or induces another person to join or remain a member of a criminal street gang. This is a new bill.
Motion.
I'll move it.
Moved by Senator O'Mara, seconded by Senator Gallivan. Any questions or comments? Senator Gianaris.
This addresses an important issue area of dealing with gang activity. I want to point out that Senator Diaz has a bill that I think is an improvement on this one and is more comprehensive. Specifically, there's one question I have about the language in this one. Among the criteria that it lists to determine whether someone is a street gang member, subdivision 6F says has been stopped in the company of known criminal street gang members 4 or more times. I don't know what stopped means, stopped by whom, stopped and recorded in some way, or what exactly does that mean?
I think this may be the same language in Senator Diaz's bill. It's similar language, and there has been cases on it from other states in New Jersey and Florida. I think that's where Senator Diaz based his bill from, which he states in his legislative intent. So I think stopped has its plain meaning, being in the company of other criminal street gang members known to law enforcement.
Do you think customary usage in the context of this criminal statute be stopped by some duly sworn member of law enforcement? I don't think it would include being stopped by a civic association or any individuals.
Not that we're debating Senator Diaz's bill, but I don't see where it has reference to that in his legislation. But I think it's easy enough to clarify what stopped means to avoid having a language that's overbroad and doesn't do what it's intended. I tend to be without rec on this and hope that the sponsor, given the table, clarifies that before it gets...
Senator Lance can resolve that easily enough to make reference to law enforcement.
Thank you, Senator. We will sit down and try to figure it out.
Thank you.
Be more specific there.
Any other questions or comments? Negative votes. Senator Jay Harris without rec, Senator Perkins without rec. Senate 4436A, my bill.
This is an act to amend the penal law in relation to concurrent and consecutive terms of imprisonment. This bill requires inmates convicted of penal law crimes, convicted of crimes against any employee of the Department of Correctional Services, to be sentenced consecutively upon such conviction to the sentence they are serving prior to the new conviction. It passed the Senate 58-4 in 2011.
Move the bill.
Seconded by Senator Galvin. Questions or comments? Negative votes?
Perkins.
Senator Perkins is a negative. Bill is reported. Senate 4938A, which if reported will go to finance, by Senator Bonasek.
This is an act to amend the executive law, town law, and the village law, and not-for-profit corporation law. The bill authorizes access to the entire criminal history reports of prospective volunteer firefighters and emergency medical service personnel and existing members of such organizations in order to determine whether there has been a conviction for certain sex offenses. Should a conviction be found, membership would be barred. Should a conviction be found for a current volunteer, that membership would be terminated. The bill allows for disqualification for a conviction of any criminal offense if it is related to the volunteer's fitness to serve. Current law only provides for disqualification for a conviction of arson.
Motion. Moved by Senator Fischella, seconded by Senator Gallivan. Questions or comments? Negative votes? And without rec, Senator Perkins, the bill is reported. Senate 5296 by Senator Ball.
Senator, this bill creates a new Class A misdemeanor for disseminating a security body scan.
Motion by Senator Fischella, seconded by Senator Gallivan. Questions or comments? Negative votes? Bill is reported. Senate 6020 by Senator Griffo.
This is an act to amend the penal law in relation to denial of parole to certain inmates. This bill authorizes the State Board of Parole to require a violent VFO to serve the maximum term if release would pose an imminent threat to society. Currently, conditional release is a statutory formula, and the Board of Parole does not have discretion to grant or deny when they reach that date an inmate. So for indeterminate sentences, an inmate must serve 2/3 of their maximum sentence, and indeterminate sentence, the inmate must serve 6/7. This bill would require them to serve the max if they are an imminent threat to society.
Motion moved by Senator Fischella, seconded by Senator O'Mara. Questions or comments? Negative votes? Without Rex, it is unanimous. Bill is reported. Senate 6035 by Senator Martins.
Senator, this is an act.
On 6020, Senator Martins without Rex. Senate 6035 by Senator Martins.
This is an act to amend the penal law. This bill raises each degree of criminal diversion of prescription medications and prescriptions in the penal law by one class, making the lowest level a Class C felony and the highest level a Class B felony.
Motion by Senator Fischello, seconded by Senator Gallivan. Any questions or comments? Please excuse my voice. I'm terribly sorry. Any questions or comments? Negative votes. Bill is reported. Senate 6075 by Senator Griffo.
Senator, this bill is similar to 6020 by Senator Griffo in that it authorizes the State Board of Parole to require felony sex offenders to serve the maximum term if release would pose an imminent threat to society.
Motion by Senator Fischello, seconded by Senator O'Mara. Questions or comments? Negative votes.
Without Rex,
Senator Gianaris, and Senator Perkins. Bill is reported. The next bill, 6508, by Senator Kennedy, who was with us, and after counsel has explained the bill, Senator Kennedy would like to be heard. Senator, that courtesy.
Sure. Senator, thank you for bringing this before the vote. I know Senator Gallivan, Senator Gianaris, and others are aware of the bill. It's sponsors of this bill in the bipartisan
fashion. May I just let the council explain, and then please, the floor is yours.
Senator, this is an act to amend the penal law in relation to assault of a child. This bill adds a new section of assault in the first degree, making it a B felony with intent to cause physical injury to a person less than 11 years old, recklessly causing serious physical injury to such a person that has previously been convicted of certain assaults. In addition, the bill also increases the predicate period for aggravated assault upon a person less than 11 years old when the defendant commits the crime. Commit certain assaults upon a person less than 11 years old. It raises that predicate period to 10 years, and then it provides a bump up to a B felony for a conviction of the aggravated assault, the second conviction of the aggravated assault upon a person less than 11 years old.
Thank you. Moved by Senator Gallivan, seconded by Senator Gina Harrison. Senator Kennedy, who's not a member of the committee, but as we have on occasion extended the privilege of addressing the committee. And
I just want to thank you, Senator, for bringing this to the floor for a vote. Thanks for the co-sponsorship from my colleagues on this. It's a little boy, he's 2 years old now. He was a newborn, just a few weeks old. His father beat him senselessly, broke 11 bones in his body. His father had been previously convicted of beating another son of his, breaking a bone in his body, but it was outside of the statute of limitations to convict him for aggravated assault. His bill would close that loophole. He also only served 1 1/3 to 4 years for the census beating, so this strengthens the law. I appreciate it so much. And a little boy was here last week with his family.
Thank you, Senator Kennedy. Any other questions or comments? Any negative votes? The bill is reported. Next bill, Senate 7267, my bill.
Senator, this is an act to amend the penal law in relation to public lewdness, the vehicle and traffic law, in relation to designating public lewdness as permanent disqualification for a bus driver, and the correction law in regard to registering public lewdness in the first degree. The bill creates a new statutory scheme for public lewdness, creating three new crimes as opposed to the single B misdemeanor that currently exists. The new crime of public lewdness in the first degree enhances penalties for persons who repeatedly commit lewd acts. The new crime of public lewdness in the second degree, a Class A misdemeanor, criminalizes those who commit the lewd acts for the purpose of sexual gratification. The first degree crime is a new Class E felony for offenders who are convicted previously of public lewdness in the second degree, or commit lewd acts against a child less than 11 years old. A conviction of the first degree crime requires registration under SORA.
Is there a motion?
No.
Moved by Senator Gennaro, seconded by Senator Lanza. Any questions or comments? Any negative votes? Senator Perkins in a negative?
Yes.
Senator Perkins in a negative. Bill is reported. Girling, do we have any additional voting sheets?
No, not enough to change that vote. We're worried about that sewer. Okay. Does that mean it's laid aside?
Yeah, her bill will be laid aside and taken up on our next agenda. Thank you.